like to open by acknowledging the traditional custodians of the land on which we meet this evening, the Whadjuk people of the Noongar Nation, and I pay my respects to their elders past and present. With me this evening is the city CEO, Lynn Russell, who you'll be familiar with, and I have apologies from my two fellow commissioners, David Gray and Steve Smith. In particular, our guests this evening are those who are standing for candidature for the upcoming elections in October. The last significant town hall meeting that I attended was with Arthur Cockie Caldwell. He spoke at the Mosman Town Hall in Sydney in around about the early mid-1960s. Somebody took a shot at him on that evening, and I hope our meeting this evening is going to be a little bit more civil than that. And I hope that we will have this opportunity to hear from our candidates and to see how we go forward. This is an important time for the city of Canberra. The city has been deprived of elected representatives on its council for some 3 years now. And come the 17th of October, that will change. Well, soon after the 17th of October, the following week, when the new council will be sworn in as your elected representatives to take charge of your city and perform their civic responsibilities on your behalf from here on in. And I'm very pleased to see we've got such a strong field of candidates who are standing for consideration by the community. And it's not something that you take on lightly. It is a responsible civic duty that is taken on. It involves a lot of time, a lot of commitment, a lot of application, and the rewards, certainly in more monetary terms, I'd have to say are modest, but the rewards can also be significant if your councillors going forward can steer the city to new heights and for the betterment of the community. It's an opportunity tonight, though, for your candidates to succinctly state their value proposition to you. It's an opportunity for you to hear from the array of candidates so that you can see who might be a suitable candidate in your eyes for your representation as a councillor of the ward or as mayor of the city. And hopefully we'll have a little bit of time whereby you might be able to ask some questions of some of the candidates to seek clarification on issues that may be of concern to you. Let me touch on a couple of housekeeping items first. You're here to hear the candidates, not me, but there is some housekeeping must go through. The emergency exits to the rear at my right, my left, and on the side of my right. The toilet facilities are just outside the door. I do ask everybody to turn their mobiles off or onto silent so that we don't have any interruption. I do ask that there be no photography. We are actually screening the presentations and they will be on the city's webpage in a few days' time. We've got a good number of people here. I anticipate some people may come and go. We've tried to structure the evening so that it is by board, the presentations with those standing for mayor or candidature in the middle, so that people may wish to leave or arrive depending upon when their board presentations are on and when the mayor's speaking, when the mayor or candidate is speaking. We will have to undergo some very strict timing for our candidates. We do expect you people to be home at a reasonable hour this evening. We're trying to wrap up here by 9:30, but with 47 or so people speaking this evening, it's going to be a little bit of a challenge. So we've only been able to allocate 2 minutes to each candidate, to each councillor candidate for speaking, and we ask that you stick strictly to that time. Madam timekeeper on my left has got strict instructions to be ruthless with the donging of the bell. There will be a tap after 1 minute to go, and then multiple rings after 2 minutes, and we do ask that you cease and close off immediately at that stage, otherwise a big crook is going to come out from the side of the stage and drag you off the podium. We will be giving 4 minutes to the mayoral candidates, and after each group of board candidates has spoken, we will have about 5 minutes of time for questions from the community of their candidates. If you ask, I will, if you have it, if you wish to ask a question, I will then acknowledge you, you stand, give your name, and ask your question. We've got some rules as to of engagement, as it were, which you've got there, and I won't go through those in detail, but I think it is important to try to get your questions very succinct. A good question would be something, where do you stand on parks and recreations? And perhaps a good answer would be, I'm fully in favour of more money being spent on parks and recreations, or something like that, rather than using it as an opportunity for a soapbox, because we'd like to give as many people an opportunity to ask questions as they can. And when we go into the questions, I will favour people who haven't spoken before, and I will favour questions to candidates who haven't been asked a question before as well. We'll have a PowerPoint going on. The rules of engagement are up there at the moment, and that will show who's speaking. Their name will be highlighted. We do have some apologies from some of the candidates this evening. In the Bannister Ward, we have apologies from Robert Morgan. In the Delia Ward, we have apologies from Rob Morsgate and Robert Bunny. In the Bailu Ward, we have apologies from Cornell Sheebling, Jeremy Hill, and Teresa Grani. In the former mayoral candidates, we have apologies from Tim Porter and Joe Belladonna. In the Mason Ward, we have apologies from Isaiah Hartley and Graham Barry. And in the Nicholson Ward, we have apologies from Megan O'Donnell. Where are we up to? So, in the middle, after we've heard, first of all, from the speakers of the Bannister Ward, some Q&A, the BDR Ward, then the BDU Ward, we'll have a 15-minute break or so. My time tips is 13 minutes. This is how closely scripted we are here. First, some tea and coffee facilities that I've had them out to outside as well. And then we'll come back and hear from the mayoral candidates, and then from those with the Mason Ward and the Nicholson Ward. Some of the mayoral candidates are also standing for a particular ward, and if they end up as mayor, then they would end up, they would be elected as mayor and not in a particular ward. Where they are standing, both as a prospective councillor and also as mayor, we have not included them as a speaker under that group of ward candidates, and their opportunity to speak will be when we consider and hear from the standing for candidates as mayor generally. So, with those opening words, I think we're reasonably on time. As always though, decisions of me, and I exercise my prerogative as chair of this meeting as to who may speak, when they may speak, and for how long they may speak. And I do ask that, just in the interests of making sure everybody gets the opportunity to speak, and we have a good orderly meeting, that I do ask that if I do ask your indulgence, you do honour that. When you are asking a question from the public to the candidates, just please give your name and that will be sufficient. On that note, I propose to pause, and we'll move then to invite those from the Bannister Ward to give their presentations, starting off with Patrick Paul. Patrick, please come forward.
My name is Patrick Hall. It'll be my great pleasure to represent Bannister Ward, the residents of Rossmoyne, Shelley, Riverton, and parts of Willerton. I grew up in Corbell Street, Shelley, where my family settled in 1961. This council needs new faces. It needs new ideas and it needs a fresh start. There's a lot of work to be done and much to be done to repair its damaged reputation. I intend to help to restore the faith and pride we once had in this great city. The people you elect will be responsible for overseeing a $100 million budget and managing the future of one of West Australia's largest municipalities. This role demands people of character, with strong communication skills and the ability to galvanise and strengthen relationships within the council itself and at all levels of the community. The role demands impartiality and the ability to consider issues based solely on their merits. And I stand here before you totally and entirely independent of party politics. I do not have an axe to grind, nor a drum to beat, nor am I a member of any self-interest group, any local self-interest group. I stand for council simply for the purpose of representing all electors equally, fairly and impartially. If you have an issue, I will be your voice. Your representative on council must be capable of articulating your issues on your behalf and also capable of negotiating outcomes that are in the best interests of our community. I'm the former CEO of Australia's oldest animal welfare organisation, the Dogs Refuge Home in Shepton Park, and executive manager of David Jones Limited, the owner of 5 successful businesses across Perth's major shopping centres, including Westfield Carousel, and I proudly serve the community as a police officer for more than 20 years. I'm currently employed by the Education Department in the Policy and Governance Directorate. I will listen to your concerns, proudly represent your interests, provide each of you with a strong voice at council, and I will really work tirelessly to restore the faith and trust in the city of Canning and its councillors. I simply need your vote to do so. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Patrick. Well, lead off, eh? Right on time, fantastic. Our next candidate, Seth Jackson. Seth, please go forward.
I'm actually really excited that we're putting on this event tonight so I can speak to you, so thanks for having me. I could probably very easily talk to you all night, but I've tried to cut it down to just a few key things that I think will show you that I have an understanding of what you need in a counsellor. If you do want some more information from me afterwards, grab me in the break or afterwards, or I've got some flyers out on the counter there, so please get in touch. The thing I really want you to know about me is that I'm a doer. And as a counsellor, there's a lot of things I want to do and a lot of ways that I'm committed to acting on your behalf. So first, I want to make sure I can act ethically and do the right thing. I was elected to the board of the Youth Affairs Council of WA a couple of years ago, and I swiftly learned that I did not quite have all of the knowledge and understanding that I needed to do that role properly, and that it wasn't very ethical for me to take on that position. So I went out and found a course that would teach me what I needed to know, fast-tracked my Diploma of Business in Not-for-Profit Governance, and it's really made a difference, and it's made me feel more comfortable that I can do the right thing for my community, who are the members of our organisation. I'm also really committed to listening to the community. I've loved getting in touch with some of you already and hearing the issues that matter to you. And I'm also really passionate about really learning about issues, doing the research, finding out what the key facts are, and also sharing that back to the community, because it is sometimes really hard to understand the processes and what happens and all of the things that you just don't know how to find information on. The third thing I want you to know about me is that I'm really big on thinking ahead as well. So I want to ensure that we take the time to make solid and visionary plans for our future, for everything from budgeting to our community revitalisation plans and infrastructure developments, because we all know that planning is the key to success. I've been able to use my skills on various committee roles I've done before, including the board of YACCA and also the Main Roads Customer Advisory Council, so I'm really confident that I have what I need to do this job well. So if you want someone who's a doer, who thinks about what is ethical and looks ahead, then I'd be really honoured to have your vote. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Steph. Timeliness is obviously a virtue around here. It's good. Our next Ben Cousins, please. Ben.
Good evening, everyone. May I say it's fantastic to see so many people turn up tonight. My name is Ben Kunzer, and I want to be your local representative in Bannister Ward, because that's the community in which I grew up in and I live in, and I want to be the best representative for the area, for our local area. I believe we have not had a strong voice in the City of Canning in Bannister Ward for too long. I want to work for you, our seniors, individuals, families, local businesses, community groups, as your local councillor and your local champion. I want to ensure that our area, our local community, is the best place to live in, to go to school, to play sport, to do business, and to raise a family. As a junior life member of the Riverton Roos Football Club, I was concerned when they didn't have access to the facilities that they needed, and they had no one to speak to. As a graduate of Rossmoyne Senior High School, I was concerned when they were trying to build a very important access road, and they had no one to speak to. And now that's built, and it's a vital piece of infrastructure for Rossmoyne Senior High School. As a former Woolerton Blues player, I'm concerned that the sports club didn't have access to their keys for nearly 6 months after it officially opened. Our area suffered without a local voice in the City of Canning. As your local councillor, I want to be there to support these wonderful local community groups that gave so much to me as I grew up. As a new fresh voice in Bannister Ward, my local priorities will include open and transparent local government, better fiscal management to keep rates low, the expansion of the Woolerton Basketball Stadium, underground power in Shelley, a new local tavern in Riverton, to investigate a low-key style coffee shop for the Shelley foreshore, and to ensure good investment in our local community. It is grossly inequitable that Canning's $525 million major infrastructure program invest a mere $5 million into Bannister Ward and the surrounding area. My name's Ben Glinzer, and I want to make sure that Bannister Ward is represented the best it can, and I ask for your support. Thank you.
Thank you, Ben. Next up, Sally Butler. Sally, please.
Everyone, and I'm Sally Butler. I love this city, where I've lived for 30 years, raised three terrific kids, taught in its schools, volunteered, treasured its natural environment, been involved in sporting clubs and much, much more. I'm standing also as a completely independent, ordinary resident with the sole ambition of service. This is a city of great diversity, with a large and brilliantly multicultural population. Its history should be celebrated, including particularly its Indigenous heritage. The people of the city are its strength, its drive, its essential resource. But I support the idea of citizen advisory panels. They tap the talents and ideas of the broader community, who also have a right to ongoing participation. The first job of the council is to maintain and improve the many basic services that people rely on daily until they're not there. Beyond that, I want to be part of continuing to build a city that is more attractive, has more interesting features, businesses, cultural and social venues and events, to be enjoyed by locals and enticing to visitors. A city that is cleaner, safer, more energy and water efficient, and easier to get around without cars. And that's a challenge. A forward-looking city, prepared to manage and shape the changes that are inevitable in life and in progress. These are all general statements, but behind them are concrete ideas. I understand there is much hard work and learning ahead, which I completely welcome. I have no doubt in my capacity to do it. I've done it repeatedly. There are many candidates standing who, individually, will win or lose. But what really counts is that the people of Canning are the winners, and I wish everyone the very best. Please find me on Facebook at Sally Boat for Canning.
Thank you. Thank you, Sally. Next, Bill Gleeson. Bill, please come forward.
I'm not Labor, Liberal or Green. I'm Bill Gleeson. That's what you see. I've lived in Riverton for over 45 years with my wife Valerie. My children went to Riverton Primary School and went to Wilson High. I am very passionate about local government. I have served in local government for 20 years as an elected member. I am qualified to do this job. I have no baggage with local government. I've never been sacked. I've been complimented with 20 years experience by WELGA, the state government, and other organisations. What frightens me is the state government are slowly taking away the power of the local council. They're whittling away the opportunity for people in the community to oppose or look at major planning issues. One issue that has never been raised in this council so far is the state government now are looking at capping council rates. Now anyone out there might say, oh, that'd be great, rates won't go up. But that can be a disaster to some respect. If I get elected, I will ask through council for the appropriate officer to write a report on the pros and cons of state government in the future, if they do, capping rates. It will be a major disaster for local government if that ever happens, as far as I'm concerned. I'm not for high rates, but I see that the only way the city of Canning can go forward is planning, and the only way you can plan is put money aside sometimes so that you can say, I've got $20 million in the bank deposit to do a project and approach other organisations federally and state to build that project. given my background and my tenacity, please vote Bill Gleeson 1.
Thank you, Bill. Invite Carolyn Dunsire to the podium. Thank you.
You all to read my profile or find a flyer out in the foyer or speak with me via email, phone or face to face. I want to talk about several matters that are for me critical to the selection in Canning. It has been suggested at some stage that Canning must not have an inexperienced council. I ask, why not? Admittedly, it's not ideal, but when I read the background, skills and experience of all the candidates here, I know from my time in education and now as a small business owner, it can be done. It may take a little bit of time, but that's the same with any new council. Councils are often thought of as rates, roads and rubbish. This is still our core business, but councils are now seriously under threat of having other levels of government push their responsibilities onto us at our cost, and it's something that I will strenuously resist. For me, the modern 3 hours of local government are research, doing the reading, clarifying, information seeking so as to be well prepared for meetings and workshops, receptiveness, to be logical, well informed and well constructed debate that is listened to with courteous open mind and is also about ongoing council education. And above all, respect. Respect for the processes that lead to good, open, transparent decision making, and once that decision is made, respecting that decision and working very hard to ensure that it is there. These are the values that I would bring to the position of councillor. Sometimes some of the people have said we don't need board member type councillors. Well, the reality is that councils are now multi-million dollar entities. Ratepayers are investing with us in their rates, and they want to live in a vibrant, well-run, enticing city that cares for its residents. People deserve councillors who will make strong decisions, who have strength and vision to make Canning a great place to live. Far too often, Canning has flown under the radar in media and bursting out for all the wrong reasons. Let's change that. Thank you.
Thank you, Caroline. Our next candidate, Michael Dendrinos. Michael.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Michael Dendrinos. What you get is right here in front of me. I'm very straight up and down. I'm not going to take any crap from anyone, and I'm going to make sure we are looked after as citizens. Everyone will say that I keep rates low. As a ratepayer, why wouldn't I want to keep rates low? That's just how it is. It's my money, I'm investing it, I want to make sure that the council is doing the right thing with my money. One of the first things I would do if I was elected as councillor would request to have a full detailed view of the books. An annual report is fantastic, but you can cook an annual report any way you want to. We need to make sure that our money is being spent wisely, that we're not planting huge trees underneath power lines. If we're doing that, we're then going to have to pay someone else to come and cut the trees. That is just unacceptable and a waste of money. I haven't been here that long. I've only lived here for 5 years, but like everyone else, I chose to live here for a reason. Good schools, good community, good neighbours, and good fun. I take my daughter for a walk to the Sheldrake Park all the time. She loves playing on the swings. Those swings were put there by the council. They were done for a good reason, to make sure that our community had somewhere for our children to grow and somewhere for our children to smile and have fun. I think we need to keep this going. I'm a strong believer in the truth of what the community has put forward to us before. Everyone here will pat each other on the back, help each other up when they're down, and smile at each other, say good day. That is what a community is about. That's what I want to keep. As a member of the Australian Services Union, one of my proudest moments was being elected Delegate of the Year. That is because I was elected by my peers as serving them well. I made sure I acted in their interests and made sure that everything was done for them. I'm not affiliated with any political party. and I want you to vote for me, Michael Andrews.
Thank you, Michael. Our next speaker is Adrian Gallo. Adrian, please come forward.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Adrian Gallo, and I'm going to start off with just a brief overview of who I am and a bit of a story and my core vision of the city of Canning. So I'm 28 years old, I'm a father, I have a three-year-old, and I have another one on the way. We love living in Riverton. We love the city of Canning. I'm a business development executive at the Duxton Hotel, but I didn't get there just because of getting as sort of a job in the hotel industry. I'm actually a painter by trade. I got I'm a painter by trade because that's what I had to be when I was younger. I had no other choice. And then from that, my trade certificate, I got into university and I studied a Bachelor of Business in Hospitality and Tourism Management, and I fell in love with my dream. My core vision for the city of Canning is sustainability, and that is the triple bottom line: culture, social, economic, and environmental sustainability. Now, the way that I want to do this as a councillor is through events and tourism. We have a beautiful park, the Canning River Regional Park, and there's a lot to enjoy. I just recently went down there only a couple of weekends ago, and I took my son and my wife, and we just can't describe how beautiful it is. We also have the Canning River Eco Education Centre, which is also a very important community building. It provides education for all of our children, awareness of the Canning River environment. Through me as being councillor, I'll be able to become a leader and also a mentor. And from that, I'll be able to provide leadership and stability and sustainability in the city of Canning. Thank you.
Thank you, Adrian. And next to you, Claire Money.
Good evening, everyone. It's a privilege to be here, and what can I say about our community? All you have to do is look at the wonderful people who've put themselves forward to know why we love living here. I thought I'd just give you a little history about who I am. I too graduated from Rossmoyne High School. I won't tell you when. I'm a teacher. I have lived overseas in Singapore and Los Angeles. I know what it's like to find yourself in a new place with nobody that you know and having to start again. So I relate to all the new arrivals in my community in Riverton. I have three children who all go to local public schools. I'm currently president of the Riverton Primary School PNC Association. I'm a past committee member and president of the Shelley Play Group. And I recently completed a public policy master's degree at Murdoch University. So that's who I am. But what do I stand for? I stand for honesty. If I'm elected to local council, I would make sure the council is honest, open, and accountable to the public. I am independent. I come with no agenda, and I'm open to all ideas to make our city a better city. I am realistic and optimistic. We have challenges as a city. We have pressures associated with urban infill, for example. But I know with creative, constructive problem solving, we can come up with solutions that enhance our communities and make them more inclusive and dynamic. I also am a great listener and communicator, and I'd like to feel that everybody felt comfortable coming to me with any issues or ideas they had, and know that they would be listened to, respected, and I would do what I can to help them. I have road safety. All right, I'll leave that. But anyway, thank you very much. I have other things I love, but we'll leave it at that. Thank you. I look forward to talking.
Thank you, Peter. Our next speaker is Peter Clayton. Peter, would you like to come forward?
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm standing for the position of Councillor of the Bannister Ward because of the credentials required. I'm a great listener and a realist. I've been a successful and innovative farmer and business person over the years, particularly in the shires of Broomhill and Katanning, where I was originally brought up. This involved the raising of finance and becoming a member of the local shire, where we got together and we built a remarkable sporting complex or recreational complex for all of the people. I was very instrumental in that. I was very, very proud of my achievements, or the council's achievements. In 1967, I was conscripted into the army and I spent 12 months in Vietnam with the 4th Battalion Royal Australian Regiment. I and my family moved to Rosmoyne in 95, and our children were educated at Rosmoyne Primary School and All Saints College. I have a very wide experience in running of businesses and the ability to look outside the square. If elected, I will do my best to work for all residents and ratepayers of Canning, to return the Canning to a lean organisation, one that is working for the residents and not staff. Under the administration, councillors lack leadership. Council fees. I will only take the bare expenses that I incur, if elected, to cover my costs. I have no political affiliations. I do not believe that politics have any part in Canning, and I do note that I fully support the Willerton basketball courts down there. I am absolutely amazed at what they were doing with the children down there and also the adults, and that really needs a big pickup. Thank you.
Thank you, Peter. Our last speaker to address us on the Bannister Ward, Mr. John Paynes. John, please come forward.
Good evening, everyone. I'm a candidate for Bannister Ward, and one who comes without a personal agenda, political affiliation, or ambition in that regard. Almost 50 years in this city sees me as a very contented resident, delighting in what our city offers. I moved here as a single man of 20, raised my family here, and met with success in business here. And after 40 years in business, now retired, I'm willing, as an unaffiliated candidate, to serve in the capacity of councillor. I use our facilities, and I'm proud to show off our stretch of the Canning River, our beautiful parklands, and other many facilities to my friends. All of them desire that they have just something even slightly similar. I have nothing negative that propels me to volunteer for the role of councillor. No dissatisfaction or angst, just gratefulness for all that we have. I've travelled extensively throughout the world and I've seen firsthand the results of bad government and the very best of good government. I want to be part of the continuing good government we've had in our city. After 40 years of business, I know that results for the good of all come with consultation and understanding, discussion, and seeing the other's point of view. I don't see any merit in fighting over issues, standoffishness, demanding, or heavy-handed behaviour. My personal desire is for this city, as it grows, and see greater involvement by its citizens in local government, to do all we can for the elderly, to engage in the youth, with the youth in local government, to help families who are failing and their children. I want to see greater involvement with our migrants. There'll be many issues that will come before council, and I can assure you that each and every one of them will get my full focus and voice, and that will ensure the best outcome for all. Thank you.
Thank you. Speaker, we've heard from 11 of our candidates for the ward of Bannister. The other one, Mr. Robert Morgan, will be on your ballot sheet. As I said, he was an apology this evening. Because we've been reasonably on time and so forth, and because we've got 12 candidates total for the Bannister ward, there must be something in the water out of Bannister or something which gets so many people up wanting to serve their communities. We'll try to stretch question time from probably 5 to 10 minutes if we can. So anybody would like to ask a question, there'll be a roving microphone. I'll need a microphone down the front as well for a response. So anybody would like to ask a question, just give your name and identify who you'd like to pose the question to. Gentlemen down the front, thank you. Microphone right behind you.
Budget. And it looks like we've been 1% being corrected for this Bannister ward for the Fish Capital Works. Can you just elaborate on how you would influence the change in that regard?
Mr. Good,
thanks, Pat, for the question. Basically, the City of Canning has an 11-plus-year major infrastructure capital works program, $525 million. $5.14 million is invested in Bannister Ward, but that includes Willerton, Greenwood, Fernow. Projects like the Willerton Basketball Stadium used to be a priority for the former council and in the City of Canning for many years. It's no longer the case. It's not on that infrastructure plan anymore. I want to make sure projects like the Willerton Basketball Stadium, it's an icon for the Willerton community, and I'm sure many of you people either play basketball or have family play there, but it's more than that. It's the low-key, look at the possibility of a low-key style coffee shop on the Shelley foreshore, things like that. More investment in the Bannister Ward, so that more, I'm not trying to detract from the projects in the other parts of Canning, but I still think that we need a focus in our part of Canning. Thanks.
Thank you for that. Next question, please. Lady in the middle. Yes, thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I'm Keiko Stein. I'd like to ask question number 9 candidate, Mrs. Claire Money. I understand that you are a teacher,
yes,
and have children,
yes,
and a family.
That's fine.
Now, how would you be able to cope with all your job if you become counsellor?
Well, at the moment, I'm just relief teaching. So I finished my degree at the end of last year, where I was working part-time, studying part-time, looking after children, having a lot on my plate. So this year I kind of had a little break for 3 or 4 months, recalibrated. I was kind of self-imposed long service leave, that's what I called it. And then when I saw the City of Canning was calling for councillors, I thought, I've done a public policy degree. I really am an enthusiastic, community-minded person. I've always volunteered in the community, and I thought this would be a perfect role for me because I'm not afraid of policy. I love to talk to different people. I appreciate that one decision isn't going to keep everybody happy, but how can we, what can we negotiate? So that's what I do.
Thank you, a busy person.
Thank you.
Thank you. I have another question, particularly for some of the other candidates. The gentleman to my left here.
Thank you, Commissioner. I'm going to pose a question to two candidates and hope that it's the same question.
Just have your name first, if you
can. Apologies. My name is Ken Moore.
Thank you, Ken.
And I'm a citizen from Rossmoyne as well. I'm going to pose a question to two candidates, Peter Clayton and to John Hayes. I'd like each of them to answer. The Optus mobile phone tower is a proposed phone tower on top of the Rossmoyne Bowling Club. That is a 10.1 metre tower which is proposed to be constructed shortly. It's gone out to objections and it is now discussion with council. What do the two persons think about this phone tower and its proposed use in the Rosslyn? Thank you.
Thank you. Maybe Mr. Clayton first, and then Mr. Hayes.
Thank you for that, Ken. Myself, I am opposed to the phone tower that is proposed for the bowling club. At the present time, that is off the agenda because they jumped the gun a little bit with that. And as I understand it, at the present time, it is not going to happen, or it's being put on hold. But I can't say anything more than that because I don't know anything. But it is very, very close to the kindergarten, the school, and even though we have a lousy telephone reception, mobile reception in Ross Point, which I complain about, I do not want to see that go ahead.
Over to Mr. Hayes. Thank you for that, Mr. Lawson.
Well, Ken,
there's
not much left for me to add to that, other than to say that many years ago I made the mistake of selling a plot of land with a phone tower on it, and the current owner is reaping wonderful rewards from it, so I understand the commercial value of some people. But personally, I would be listening to the voice of the community, and if it's fear of whatever emanates from that tower for our youngsters and our own good health, then I will listen to those voices from the community.
Thanks,
Ken.
Thanks, Mr.
Hayes.
Got a question down the back, and then we've got one down the front
here. Godfrey Lowe, Wigan Riverton. My question is to Caroline Dunside. Caroline, you mentioned transparency and openness, and you have experience with the Rossmore and Shelley Riverton Ratepayer Association. So it would be something close to your heart, I imagine. How do you propose to enhance the openness and transparency of the City Council if you're in
Thank you. Thank you, Godfrey. I think the openness is about communication. It's a two-way street. You need to listen and you need to communicate back. The community panels that are proposed for our city are a splendid idea, and I think it actually needs to be taken further. I recently went to the National Summit on the Future of Local Government in Melbourne, and a lot of discussions about public consultation there. And some things that people and other councils are doing are setting up things like blogs. So I would envisage perhaps blogs within our wards that allow people to communicate with the councillors, maybe something like the Addisford Bugle or the Nicholson News or the Basin Mumbles, who knows what you want to call it. The other thing too is I think that councillors need to be open and accessible to the community. And I would envisage in my case something like being available on, say, the first Wednesday of the month for people to come and talk to me. Those sorts of lines of openness and communication. Does that help?
Thank you. Thank you. Got a question down the front end, probably our last one on this band of questions. Thank you.
My name is Peter Rim, and I would like to speak to this young lady again. Caroline, my question is, as a former school teacher or principal, as well as a small business owner, you're most likely now how to handle financial management. And what do you think is the problem is our council it has now mismanaged for several years the financial situation? Thank you.
That's a very interesting question, and without sounding like Sir Humphrey Appleby, it's a very difficult thing because I'm not on council. I don't have access to all the information and those sorts of things. I think people are probably thinking rates have gone up quite a lot. Yes, our rate rise was big, it was about 7.4%, but overall our rates when compared to our neighbours are still very low. I don't know if you saw the people on PR and Waters who were complaining, I pay less rates than they do. The finances, I think, are very important. We have to have a sustainable city. We need to have that balance between our income and our expenditure so that we can have the little extra luxuries just like a family does, but we need to have something put aside for the future. We can't spend the kids' inheritance. It's not that. We've got to have something there to do it with. But until I was elected and actually had those thorough briefings, I think that's the best answer I can give you, and I hope that that's adequate.
Thank you very much. I'll close off Q&A for our Bannister Ward candidates at this time.